The COVID-19 pandemic that has ravaged the world for 2.5 years has had adverse effects on all aspects of the health sector.
So this support which Uganda has received, which is about $4.5 million over the 4 years, has supported the government at the national level to bring together these different sectors, health, education, gender, to examine the existing policies as whether they support that sort of thinking.
In Uganda, COVID-19 worsened the sexual reproductive health, HIV prevalence rate, gender-based violence, tuberculosis, and the national nutritional services. In the wake of events, the Ministry of Health with other stakeholders in the health sector have today launched the national strategy to integrate all the 6 health concerns.
They must understand that we must uphold the rights of people. We shouldn't be fighting, we shouldn't be violent, we shouldn't be abusing each other. So this integration needs to be developed right from the community level for people to understand how they can prevent certain illnesses to happen, that each of them has a right anyway to be respected as an individual, even for just a couple in the home to understand that a woman has her individual rights. She should not be abused.
Integration seeks to enhance resource efficiencies, strengthen systems, improve healthcare programming and service provision. While launching the National Strategy of Integration at a one-day National Learning Symposium of the joint program between the Government of Uganda and the UN on Integration in Kampala, the Minister of State for Primary Healthcare, Anifa Kawoya Bangilana, called for a better approach to ensure availability of essential drugs for the 6 health concerns.
To ensure the availability of commodities for both SRH, HIV, TB and other diseases at the health facilities to prevent stockouts of essential commodities for these diseases.
Kawoya expressed concerns about the fluctuating supply of medical supplies characterized by endless stockouts and mismatch of drugs.
We find these essentials are not there. At times we find there is a weak system. You must address that. At times you find that the essentials are not in time.
Kawoya emphasized the urgent need to improve the health infrastructure to adhere to the confidentiality while administering treatment of HIV, TB, sexual reproductive diseases and others.
There's a need to improve the infrastructure at the health facilities to privacy and confidentiality while providing integrated services as far as social reproductive health, HIV, gender-based violence is concerned.
The minister called for training of health extension workers in communities on the delivery of sexual reproductive health, HIV and gender-based violence services to the people. She also underscored a need to sensitize the public to understand their rights to access medical treatment.
Gender-based violence is done around us and around somewhere. So it is high time that if our communities, they know their rights, and if they know their rights, that they can also do their action as these dogs did.
The UNFPA Deputy Country Representative Abigail Semburi applauded Uganda for integrating SRH, HIV and gender-based violence, saying it will go a long way in tailoring effective and sustainable interventions and achieving the Sustainable Development Goals agenda. She called upon all stakeholders in communities to join hands to fight teenage pregnancies by scaling appropriate sexual education to the adolescents. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.